Samantha here, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. I know it's been so long and I haven't recorded anything for you guys in such a long time because I am working extensively hard on finishing the room because I have a timeline that is fixed between right now and the end of February. And yeah, I think I have to have finished this room by the time I reach 26 years. Yes, I am going to turn 26 on the 26th of February, so I'm pretty excited. So today I'm going to be talking to you guys. This is actually a sit-down video. We're not reacting, we're not doing any makeup or anything, but I'm just going to be talking to you guys about the situation in Zimbabwe and what I feel is happening to a lot of creatives, a lot of youth in Zimbabwe in regards to the economy and the mental state of the mind. Now, in my case, I would say that I can confidently say that I have had my fair share of mental issues over the past, I can say 3 years, because I finished my varsity in 2016 and I graduated with a bachelor's in commerce in marketing from the National University of Science and Technology. So when you are in university, you normally have this mindset that as soon as I finish school, maybe I'll just have a gap, like rest period of like 6 months, and then you get a job. But then with the status of Zimbabwe, everything just went downhill. Now, personally, as a creative, because I had started my magazine in 2014, I thought maybe I could juggle the world of being a magazine editor, publisher, founder, at the same time trying to look for a job and also maintaining my online business. So I was doing thrift business, I was doing my magazine, all in the space of the time that I was waiting to get a job. And it was pretty stressful because when you're dealing with things like digital media in Zimbabwe, not many people understand digital media. So trying to explain a magazine, a digital magazine, to someone was quite a mammoth task. So during that period, until the time I got a job, in 2018. I was just hustling. I was in between jobs. And when you are an entrepreneur, trust me, you will definitely go through a lot of mental issues. I don't know if I can say I was depressed. I never went to see a health professional for that, but I exhibited the symptoms of being depressed a lot. And the hardest thing was talking to someone like my mom or my dad, because depression is something that a lot of black families really talk about, or Zimbabwean families per se. So usually you keep everything inside and then you struggle with it time after time. And the thing with talking about mental issues and a traditional African home is that not many parents understand depression. They might think that it's an excuse of someone who doesn't want to confront what they are faced with. Or you can be taken to church. You are simply possessed, simple as that, and then you know what happens next. So I didn't tell anyone until I think 2018, when I really felt that I was really going downhill. I think at that particular point I was having anxiety attacks, panic attacks. I never even told my sister, for crying out loud. I only opened up to my best friend, and I wouldn't say it was really opening up. I think I vented. I didn't get to the point of what was really happening with me. And it really takes a lot of time to recover from that. So I started spacing myself on social media. Of course, I'm always on social media. But then I had to refresh and go back to the drawing board. Look at everything that was making me go through all those steps, because I had a dream to have moved out of my parents' house by the time I was 25. I had a dream I would maybe be driving a car, but you go, don't got a license till now. And I was expecting to be taking care of my parents. That was the thing that was really sitting on my chest, because I really, really do believe in black tax. A lot of people don't, but I do, because I feel it's my duty to give back to the people who brought me to this level of education, where I am physically, mentally, everything. So that was the part I was struggling with. And I got a job, but then it was just a temporary job and it wouldn't really cover for what I had in mind. So it was quite difficult. So I'm just going to give you guys the three things I did to really get over my, I don't know, almost depression, or what I can call it. I can call it a funk maybe, but it wasn't a funk because I had sleepless nights, because I read somewhere that one of the symptoms of depression is you may be restless, you don't sleep, but then you also sleep into the day, you sleep longer than normal. And I was always cancelling up on people. That's another sign. You cancel appointments, you just don't feel like going out. And some people experience weight gain, some experience weight loss. I was in between somewhere there because I'm still fat as ever. But anyway, the three things I did to really get out of that space were to basically, number one, I talked to someone. And I think I felt more comfortable talking to someone I really do not know, because when you're talking to someone you know, you feel like you have to hold back on some things, you feel embarrassed because you feel like you're a failure. So I talked to a lady who I met on WhatsApp, and she was in my prayer group, and you know, it was just magic. We hit it off and now we're still talking and everything. The second thing I did was to reevaluate, because when you are constantly on social media, you will get lost somewhere and you will believe that you're supposed to be in a certain space when it's not your space. Everyone's got their own race, their own space, and you have to realize that this is not my race. I have to look at my own race and just look forward to that. So I worked on that. That's why people won't believe when I say I cut down on social media, but I know how bad it was, so I really worked on that. And the last thing I did was to like list down the objectives, the aims, the goals that I had. And now I can safely say 2019 has started on a really good note, because I had been, you know, procrastinating on even doing my room. And that was one of the things that I noticed when I was in that funk. I would always plan, I would plan, but I would never execute, because I was really tired mentally. So it was really taking a toll on everything that I wanted to do. But then when you set your goals, don't overset or go beyond what you can work with. I set really realistic goals. When they say SMART goals, they really mean it. That's specific, measurable, attainable, realistic, and time what I've forgotten. But basically those were the three things I did. I haven't really seen a professional for that, but I feel like if I ever feel like I am going down again, I will have to engage professionals. I know that online there are certain websites that you can go and get a counselor for free. I will link them right down below. And yeah, you can basically try and get out of that funk as soon as possible. It's not something that you should be ashamed of. It's common, and I believe and I feel a lot of young Zimbabweans are going through that, because as creatives we are really disadvantaged in this country. We really are. So that was all from my wise talk with you guys. Until next time, annyeong, keseyo.